The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th Canto, 6th Chapter, Text Number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 9th, 1975, in Vrindavan, India.
Translation: in tender childhood age, when everyone is bewildered, he passes 10 years. Similarly, in boyhood, being engaged in sporting and playful things, another 10 years. In this way, 20 years are wasted. Similarly, in old age, when a person becomes invalid and he is unable to execute even material activity, he passes another 20 years wastefully.
Muktasyabhadi koishare pirato jati vinshati jaraya grasya devasya jati akalpasya vinshati. So 50 years out of 100 years, 50 years wasted by sleeping. And then balance 50 years, 20 years in childhood and youthhood, sporting, playing. Another 20 years in old age, jarayagrastha, janmamitu, jarabhyadhi, these are inevitable, as birth is inevitable, death is inevitable, similarly, old age is inevitable. So in this way, our time is wasted. Because we do not know how valuable this human form of life is. There is no such education. They think human life is as cheap as dog's life, but factually it is not. Bahunam janmanavant. One gets this human form of life, 8,400,000 species of life, especially advanced life, the Aryan civilization. Aryan means advanced, advanced in spiritual knowledge. The materialists, they claim Aryan only from the bodily conception, but that is not the fact. Any man who is advanced in spiritual life, they are called Aryans. Rajajustam. Arjuna was chastised by Krishna that you are talking like non-Aryan, unarjajustam. So non-Aryan and Aryan, what is the difference? The Aryan civilization means this varnasanga, four varnas, four asanga. And non-Aryan means there is no division. Everyone is one or equal. That is advocated now, at the present moment. In India also, they think of casteless society. No caste. But it is not caste. It is a division of culture. Brahmana means advanced in culture, Kshatriya means less advanced than the Brahmana, and Vaishya means less advanced, and Shudra is less advanced, and the Panchamat, fifth grade, sixth grade, Kirata Hunanda Pulinda Pukkasa Veera Sumbha Javana Khasadaya, they are less. In this way, high grade and low grade division of the society, one who follows the high-grade culture, they are called Aryans, Arjuna. In many places in Vedic literature, the superior person is addressed as Arjuna. So, without being culturally advanced, they do not know the value of life, the vertical life. The advanced persons, they try to reduce waste of time. We have already discussed that the Goswamis, they were ministers, they came to Vrindavan not for begging but for advancing the spiritual culture of life. Vrindavan is not meant for making a solution of the economic condition. One who has nothing to eat outside, they should come and beg chapati and roti from door to door. The Rupa Goswami did it, Madhukari. Rupa Goswami used to beg, not beg collecting 20 chapatis, and only one or two, that's all. Not to collect the chapatis and sell it in the market and get some money and purchase biri. This is not Rupa Goswami. And just to have a loincloth imitating Rupa Goswami and having so many illicit connections, this is spoiling. Rupa Goswami came on the order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to rejuvenate, re-excavate this land of Vrindavan. And they were engaged in the service of Lord Chaitanya for preaching word. Whatever we are preaching now, it is based on the principles laid down by the Bhushan. Narottamdas Thakur has sung, Rupa Raghu Natha Pade Khaive Akuti Kave Hama Bujha Vase Jugala Piri. The loving affairs of Radha and Krishna, that is not ordinary, just material things as we conceive. Generally, people are very much interested in painting picture of Radha Krishna's love. And these pictures are very popular because they think Krishna is like us. He is after young girls. So, he is a great support for us. We are also after young girls. So Krishna has done, so we are doing that. So Krishna appears different. Narottamdas Thakur says, Rupa Raghu Natha Pade Haive Akuti Kame Hama Bujhavase Jugala. It is not so easy to understand the loving affairs of Radha and Krishna. It is meant for the most advanced spiritually. That is not ordinary thing. Not only the loving affairs of Krishna and Radharani, but everything. They are not material. They are all spiritual. It has nothing to do So how it is spiritual, that we have to understand through the teachings of Rupa Goswami, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Nectar of Devotion. Without reading all these books, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Bhagavad Gita, if we jump over Srimad Bhagavatam to understand Radha Krishna, that is not good. Therefore it is not effective. Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipuno Sadharma Sangasthapako Lokana Ankita Karino Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghu Jivo Sri Jivo. Goswami will find in the Nectar of Devotion so many Vedic literatures are quoted. So that is required. Shastra Vidhi, then will be fixed up. Vidhi Bhakti is very important. Then Raga Bhakti, then Prema Bhakti. So we should not imitate Prema Bhakti without going through Vidhi Bhakti. This is Vidhi Bhakti. Just like we rise early in the morning, perform Mangala Arati, all regulative principles, then wash the temple, dishes, and then dress the deities, then again Arati, then class. In this way, according to, because we have no natural, we have not awakened yet our natural love for Krishna. So it requires practice, practicing this Vidhi Bhakti, compulsory. Vidhi Bhakti means the injunction of the Shastras and the order of spiritual knowledge, where one has to follow. Not whimsically we can do anything. Vidhi Bhakti is required. Yasastra Vidhi Mutsrijya Vartate Kamakara Nasal Siddhi Nasiddhi, what is that? Navapnati Siddhi Nasukhanga Naparanga. So in the beginning, near five stage, not that because we have come to Vrindavan, immediately we have become advanced. No. Vidhi Bhakti must be followed. Regulated by the injunction of the Shastra and by the order of spiritual master. Vidhi Bhakti. Krishna himself says, the Shastra Vidhi Utsidya. Rupa Goswami has said also, Shuti Siti Puranadi Pancharatriki Vidhi Gimina. Again, Vidhi. Shuti Siti Puranadi Pancharatriki Vidhi Gimina. Vaikantiki Harer Bhakti Utpataye Vakalpate. If you do not follow the Vidhi as they are given in the Vedas, Shruti, and Smriti, as in the Bhagavad Gita. Shruti, Smriti, Puranani, as in the Puranas, Padma Puran, Brahma Vaivarta Puran, Agni, Agni Puran, Sattvic Puran. So Shruti, Shruti, Smriti, Puranani, and Pancharatri, Narad Pancharatri. Sarva-pādhi-vinirmaktam tat-paratena nirmalam rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti-vichyat. This is Pancharatri. Our, in this age, Pancharatri-vidhi, not Vaidhi. Vaidhi is very, very strict. Unless one is not born by a Brahmin father, he is not given the advantage of becoming a Brahmin. That is Vedic vidhi. But Panchratri vidhi means, although he is not born of a Brahmin family, if he has got a little tendency to become a Brahmin. Brahmin means Brahmajanati iti Brahmin. One who is inquisitive to understand Brahma, Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Shabda, he should be given charm. Just like there is a little fire, fanning, and it becomes a big fire. So our process is that anyone, Kīrātahu nāndra pulinda kukkasā, what you speak of the śūdra, Sriyā śūdra tathā vaiśyā. In the ordinary way, the Sri, woman, śūdra, the fourth great man, and vaiśyā, they are taken together, not very intelligent. But Pañcarātrika vidhi offers facility in persons who are lower than the Sriha Sudra Vaishya. Kiratahu nandra pulinda pukkasa vira sumbha javanakasada. Jannetu papa, and less than that, jannetu papa, jadupasrayasraya. Jadupasraya, a devotee, if you are a devotee of the Lord, and if these persons take shelter of a pure devotee of the Lord, then śuddhanti, they become purified by following the injunction of the spiritual master. He knows how to deal with them, how to elevate them to the brahminical position. So that is not artificial. Śāstra says, Bhāgavata says, yes, by such expert management, these kirātahu-nāndra, lower than the śūdra, śuddhanti. That's like people protest, because we are giving the position of a brāhmaṇa to the mṛcchaya-javana, javanākhasādha. Khasada means Mongolians, the Chinese, Japanese, and the Philippines. They are Khasada. The Manipuris, Assamese, they are considered as Khasada. So there is no distinction. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given open declaration. Krishna bhajanate nahi jati kuladi vicha. Anyone who is desirous of becoming Krishna conscious, it is open. Anyone can come. By proper training, by the expert spiritual master, everyone can be raised to the brahminical platform, and then Vaishnava platform, śuddhanti. So, how śuddhanti? The general process is that unless one is not born in Brahmin family, he is not śuddha. He is impure by birth. That is fact. But the devotee can change. This is new birth, undoubtedly. Just like this, our European American students, they are in new birth. They have given up their old birth practices. So birth is changed. Punarjanma. So that is possible only by Krishna consciousness. If one has to change his body without changing body, the body is changed, but we see that the same body, but it is not the same body. It is chinmad. The same example, that's the iron rod put into the fire, it becomes red hot. So it is no longer iron, it is fire. Similarly, if we constantly keep ourselves in touch with Krishna consciousness, then the body is no longer material, it is spiritual. Therefore, the spiritual body is not burnt, they are kept samadhi. Just like in Western countries, they give samadhi to everyone, tomb and tombe. In India, the tomb is offered to a very advanced spiritually person. You'll find many tombs in Vrindavan because their body is spiritual. This is the idea. So, there are so many things to be done for cultivating spiritual life in the human form of life. The Prahlad Maharaj is giving account that 50 years in sleeping and 20 years in playing and 20 years in old age and 10 years simply being absorbed what to do, then life is spoiled. Don't do this. Don't do this. You have got the there is a Bengali song, Pecha Manava Janma Amanjanam Arpavena. Fortunately, you have got this human form of life, you will not get this opportunity. Don't spoil. So, let us follow, we have come to Vrindavan, let us follow the Goswami's Rupa Raghunatha Pade Haive Akuti. We should be very, very anxious to follow the principles laid down by the six Goswamis. Rupa Raghunatha Pade Haive Akuti, Kabe Hama Bujhama Sri Jugal. Rupa Raghunatha Pade Rahumare As, Prarthana Karaye Sada Narottama Das. Prarthana karaye sada narottama das. Narottama das, he has sung so many Vedic songs. Narottama das's song, although it is written in Bengali, it is considered as Shruti Vedic. Srinivasa Acharya has eulogized Narottama Das Thakur, that your songs are Vedic evidences. Whatever Narottama Das Thakur has said in simple Bengali songs, they are all Vedic injunctions. Therefore, Narottama Das Thakur's prarthana are very popular and famous among the Vaishnava, Gaudiya Vaishnava, and others also. So we should not waste our mugdhasa, be fooled, or illusion, mugdhasa. Don't be illusion. Even balle, in child, they should not be, because there is no question of balla or vidha. At any moment, the life can be finished. There is no guarantee, because he is a child, he has got 100 years age, well, let him play now. No, let him play. He should be trained up. This is the duty of the father and mother. Namo chairita samupriyata mittu. One should not become father, one should not become mother. If he is not very careful to save the child from the imminent death. The imminent death does not mean motor accident. Imminent death means we are in the cycle of birth and death. It is the duty of the father and mother, the duty of the guru, the duty of the relative to save one another from the cycle of birth and death. This is real upakara. To save from the cycle of birth. Namo chayad cha samapita mrittum. This life, we are thinking that I am 8 years old or 9 years old, but it is not 8 years, it is mrittu. Mrittu, you are dying every moment. It is the life of mrittu. Therefore one has to say, Namo chayad cha samapita mrittum. A child is grown up, 5 years old, suppose he will live 100 years. So that means he has already died 5 years. Therefore it is mrittu. Or we are grown 8 years old, that means suppose I live 100 years, but still I have already died 8 years. Therefore it is mrittu. The whole life is mrittu. Every moment we are dying, dying, dying. From the very birth, suppose a child is born 1 hour before. So 1 hour past means he has died 1 hour out of 100 years. The beginning of death. This is called mrittu. So we are thinking we are growing, we are living. This is all mugdha, bewildered. Where you are growing, you are living, you are dying every moment. So dying, death is going on. It is called mrittu lok. So long you are in the material world, you are simply dying. That's all. At the end, when the balance of life it become all finished, we take at that time it is mrittu, but no. From the very birth there is mrittu. All. Dying, 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 dying. So, mugdha, we are thinking we are living and growing young, we have let his friend, but he does not know that he is dying. Therefore it is explained mugdha, so illusion. He is taking death as a life. Mugdha. So one should not be so bewildered, mugdha. And waste time by playing. Human life is not meant for. Similarly, jaraya grastha, dehasya, akalpasya, this is also very important. Generally, the old man does not know what is going to happen. He is in the hands of the nature. Ask anybody, any big man, old man, what you are going to do. I met some very important old man in London. One, he was Lord
Brockway,
I think. I asked him, what will you do? What is the end of your life? No, I shall die peacefully. He doesn't know that what is going to happen. Because the Christians, they do not believe in the next life. They think this life is finished, everything is finished. But that is not the fact. Because they cannot find out the soul, but that requires expert knowledge. Just like gold mine, Apparently, it appears that this is his store. But one who is expert, soil expert, he can understand here is gold. It's like when I was in South Africa, even in the city, Johannesburg, there are so many gold mines within the city, gold mines. So, ordinary man, how it is, how he'll know that there is gold in this soil? He must be expert to find out the soul within this body. It is not the business of rascals and fools. He must be very expert, exactly like the soil expert. And then by analysis, this is called neti-neti, no-iti. This is very easy. If you think, study your body, take this finger, so you will say, my finger. Nobody will say, I finger. Just like we sometimes examine little child, what is this? Finger. So, the finger, whose finger? My finger. Head, my head. Leg, my head. Everything, mine. And where is I? This is intelligence. Everything is studying mine. And who is I? This very question will establish the fact, dehinasmin-yathadehi, that I is within this body. Therefore I am speaking mine. So if one is expert in understanding and analyzing this body, neti-neti, this is blood, this is skin, this is this, this is this, this is urine, this is twill, whole body we analyze. Then where is that I? No, we cannot see. But how we cannot see? As soon as the eye is off, then whose tool, whose skin, whose bone? In this way, if we analyze, then we can understand that asmin dehe, within this body, the eye is there. And what is this eye? Again, aham brahmasmi, this is further advancement. But this is rascal, aham brahmasmi means I am God. No! Take concern, Bhagavad Gita, what is this aham? Aham means the part and parcel of the Supreme Brahma, Parabrahma. Krishna is Parabrahma. Param Brahma Param Dham Pavitram Paramam Bhavam. So Krishna says, these Brahmas, these living entities, they're my part and parcel. That is our understanding. I, what I am part and parcel of Krishna. So one has to study the body, where is the I. Then what is the relationship of the I? What is the position of the I? What I am? This is intelligence. This is intelligence. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu begins from here to teach Sanatana Goswami that this we are Jiver Sarupaya Nitya Krishna Das. This is the beginning of Chaitanya's teaching. Therefore, rascals, they cannot understand what is the movement of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They think that this crazy fellow unnecessarily chanting and dance. Because they cannot understand what is this movement. This movement starts when one can understand what is I. From that point it starts. So what they will understand? Unless one comes to the understanding point, what I am, what he will understand Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement? That is the defect. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so kind that without understanding, being a fool number one, if he simply joins Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's chanting and dancing, he understands immediately. Chaita Darpana Mahaprabhu. Immediately. And he understands what I am. So we should not waste our time, mugdhasya, balle kaisara, and foolish old man with disease and invalidity. No. We should immediately begin our spiritual life, aham brahmasmi. That is called Brahma Bhuti. If we come to this point, aham brahmasmi, I am Brahma, I am not this body, that is very fortune, good fortune. The people and all men throughout the whole world, they are under this bodily concept of life, and they cannot find out where is the soul, where I am. So they are all fools and dustheads. So if one comes by cultivation of knowledge, spiritual knowledge, comes to understand that I am within this body, that is called Brahma-bhūta, Brahma-jñāna, aham brahmāsmi. Brahma-bhūta prasanna-ātmā na śrūyate na kāṅkṛti samasarveṣu bhūteṣu madhbhakti labhate param. In this way, from the beginning of devotional life,